Today we're going to look at many ideas about the space on our papers. Last week we talked about drawing big. That was when we made our dots. This week we will look at filling the whole paper. We're also going to look at taking our lines off the edges of the paper, as well as overlapping. And I'm also going to have two bonus tips about some big ideas, and that's called positive space and negative space. And we're all going to do this with one piece of paper. So before we begin this lesson, you're going to need some leaves. So if you're watching this video, stop the video and go outside and collect some leaves. Now you don't want them to be so crispy crunchy that they fall apart on you. So you're going to need a variety, like, you know, big ones, little ones. Just make sure they're not so dry that they fall apart. So, hopefully you've gone out and collected your leaves. So, these are my leaves that I got. They might not all work, but we're going to be using the leaves as something called a stencil in this project. So, a stencil is like a pattern that we use to create a design. So an example of a stencil typically is like little cutouts, for example, and then you can kind of trace the shape. And then no matter how many times you trace it, you end up getting, in fact, I'm just going to scribble inside this, you end up getting the same shape. So that's kind of cool. People use stencils all the time to make designs and they're probably most commonly used on our own roads when you see all those little dots. So, and words. So anyway, as you can see, we've got a couple star stencils. We're not going to use those today, but we're going to use leaves like a stencil in the sense that we're going to trace around them. So for example, I've got my little piece of paper here, and I said kind of collect an assortment of leaves. So, you know, a mixture of different sizes. Now, if I told you, look, this one's falling apart. Look at that. That one's going in the garbage. Oh, well, now I've only got two choices. So I've got this one and that one. So I've got these two leaves, and what I can do, this is probably easiest to do with this little one, is I'm just going to trace around it. And obviously, this is going to be my little leaf shape that I can use. I'm going to hold it in place with one hand, trace around it with the other one, and lo and behold, look, I have a leaf shape. Now, if I want to go ahead and look at my leaf and draw some of the little veins that I see on it, I can do that too. And notice I'm using a crayon, so it's a little broken crayon. Oh, well. But you're going to be using a crayon too because before this lesson is over, I'm hoping that we can use something we learned about earlier, which is wax resist. You probably remember using that earlier when we did our watercolor painting worksheet. So, anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and try to trace this one. This one's going to be a little bit harder. And I'm just going to trace all the little shapes. And I like this because it's not, you know, nature has a way of providing very organic shapes. Uh-oh. So, coming really close to the other leaf. And there we go. So they're not like the geometric shapes that we've been learning about, like the circles and the squares and the triangle. Organic shapes are shapes that tend to not be so even, you know, where they're not the same on one side as they are on the other. When, you know, that means symmetry is what we call that, when something is the same on one side as on the other. So organic shapes tend to not have a lot of symmetry, or they're not what we say symmetrical. So anyway, so I can, again, add a couple veins similar to what I'm seeing on the leaf. You're just going to have to take my word for it that I saw that. So, if I told you I could fit 20 of these leaves, you'd probably say, what? I don't think so. You really can. We can do this because, number one, we are going to be filling our whole paper. And we're going to do something which is called overlapping. So what I can do is I can take my leaf and I can cover one of the other leaves, and I'm going to trace around it and look at that. I just stopped when I got to the other leaf. In other words, like I didn't go ahead and draw through that other leaf. I just stopped when I got to the other leaf, and then check it out. Now it looks like my first leaf is on top of my second leaf. And I can actually just keep doing that. I can do it over here. You know, I can take my little leaf and just continue to make it look like there's other leaves underneath the original leaves that we drew. And so, you know, obviously if I kept doing that, I could probably fit maybe another 10 leaves on there. But there's another thing that we could learn about too, which is taking our lines off the edge of the paper. Because sometimes when we draw something, we tend to plant it right in the middle and say, look at this, look what I made. Like if I were to ask you to draw a house, you'd probably plant it like right there, there's my house. Well, in real life, things don't always work like that. You know, if we're drawing a tree, for example, sometimes the tree doesn't fit neatly within the boundaries of our paper. Sometimes things go off the edge. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my little stencil leaf and I'm going to take it right off the edge of the paper. In other words, half the leaf is off the edge of the paper. And I'm going to stop and then I'm going to trace it as if the whole thing is there. And so now I have a leaf going off the edge of the paper. I'm going to take another one up here and do it up there. And I can choose to have as much of that leaf as I want. And I can even take the bigger leaf and use some of their, you know, this big leaf has some really crazy shapes. So I might want to take advantage of that. And, of course, bring those little veins on there. So now, as you can see, I'm starting to have a very interesting arrangements of shape. And I've got some overlapping happening. I have some lines going off the page. I have some leaves on top of other leaves. And it's starting to look really interesting. My composition, which is the arrangements of shapes on the page, is looking very interesting too. It's a little more unusual. You know, it's not just one fat leaf in the middle of the page or two leaves next to each other like they're best friends. The leaves, in other words, the objects that take up the space, this is called the positive space. So in other words, we understand these to be leaves that are taking up the space in our picture, or they are the focus of our picture. But then there's also another space called the negative space. And the negative space is kind of the empty space, which helps outline the shapes. So, for instance, I don't know if you know this, but this is kind of a secret. A lot of artists create the positive space by coloring in the negative space. And I'm going to show you what that looks like. So I'm going to take my little paintbrush and I'm going to dip it in some, I'm going to use black paint just because I think that's going to show it the best. So I'm just going to go ahead and start filling in or painting my negative space. Boy, we can really see all the different leaves now, can't we? And of course, we've also in the past learned about things like warm and cool colors. So for instance, here's a little thing to remember about warm colors. So those are the colors that suggest warmth, such as reds, yellows, and oranges. So what if I go ahead and paint my leaves with some of those warm colors? Because obviously they were pretty warm, except for that one was kind of brown. So I'm going to go ahead and just start painting this one pretty orange. Now, we talked a little bit about wax resist a little bit earlier. That's where if I did this in crayon, what's going to happen is the crayon is going to resist the paint I put on top of it. And that's kind of fun because that means I can just go ahead and paint over my lines and not really worry about them disappearing on me. So again, I'm going to mix some of my colors. And again, I'm just painting right over the crayon. And the crayon, because it's got so much wax in it, is going to resist the water and just poke right through it. And that kind of makes it easier when you're a painter because then you don't have to be so careful. Now look, I painted over that little leaf. I shouldn't have done that. So I'm going to go ahead and paint that little leaf a different color. I'm going to paint it that red, deep red color that we know that it was. So, and then I can paint each one of my leaves a different warm color. I'm going to paint that one yellow. And, ooh, I think I'm going to paint some a little bit on the brown side. And the ones going off the page, I don't want to ignore them. And again, I can even just kind of, I don't have to paint them all one color. I can kind of add the different colors. I can even look at my leaves and kind of see the little differences within each leaf. Because, you know, leaves, they tend to be a little bit yellow, a little bit, sometimes there's even a little bit of green left. This is kind of the perfect fall project, if you ask me. And there we go. So anyway, so what we have here is a little pile of leaves that we've made in celebration of the end of fall, or fall coming to an end. So we've got our negative space, which is this dark color around the leaves. We've got the positive space, which is the leaf. We have our overlapping. We have our lines going off the page. And finally, we have filled in our whole paper. So that is the lesson. I hope you guys have fun. And I hope you're able to find some very interesting leaves.